the left lane. This weekend racing, we're coming from No Problem Raceway in Belrose, Louisiana for the Southern Big Buck Nationals. Now, today is day two of the three-day weekend. Yesterday was Friday, and we started off with a all-run gambler's race that took 9 rounds to win, and we were able to top the 200-car field and get the win last night. So we started off the weekend with a good win, but I wasn't recording, so we didn't get that footage, but we're going to start recording today. If they got $10,000 to win in Super Pro and $3,000 to win in Foot Break, and we'll just be doing double teched in the no box Foot Break category. But yeah, we did good last night. Got all the way down, and at one point I won 13 straight rounds and won the ninth round late last night about 1:30 and got the big check. So Cody Pullidge and Johnny Ezell put on this race. It's the fourth annual race, and they do a hell of a job, and the car count keeps growing and growing. They probably have over 250, 275 cars at this event. And I'm glad for those guys that they're getting to make it, you know. Keep putting on races like this will be fun. But we're going into first round right now. I'll be in the left lane. I'm dialed a 649. Which should put me holding about 2 to 3 numbers. And I'm gonna shoot to be 30 or better on the tree, holding 2 to 3 numbers. And I'm running a car in the right lane, he's dialed 595. So my strategy is to nail the tree and get rid of the 2 or 3 numbers I need down there. So I'll give you the details when we get back to the trailer. The tree, my opponent was a little late. I think he was 59. He goes dead on with the 4, and I go 653 with a 2 on the 649, taking 10,000 strike. So it was a good run. It shows me probably running a 13, 48. So I was only holding 1. I thought I might have been holding 2 to 3, but I was only holding 1. So that's why I probably ran a little bit higher over my dial than I really wanted to, because I really wasn't down there trying to really cut them in. I just was going down there and trying to kill the 2 to 3 numbers I wanted. So I went an 83. It looked like I had a pretty good amount of room down there, but I went a 53 on the 49, thinking I was holding 2 to 3. So if I'd have killed my 2 to 3 running the 48, that should have put me at a 50 or 51, so I actually probably killed 1.5 to 2 numbers too much. But anyway, had a good light. We won that one, don't have to buy back. This race is first or second round buybacks, so I'm gonna win these first 2 rounds. That way, at worst, I can buy myself back in the 3rd round with both check cards. So we're going up right now. After I cool the car down for a quick minute, we're gonna go up there for round 1, check card 2. All right, here we go. Round 1, check card 2, back in the left lane. I'm running a car that's dialed 650, so I matched them on the dial. I'm going 650 myself. I was 649, so I figured we'll just dial heads up. I needed to dial up a little bit anyway. I think the car's, with the heat out and the cloud cover, I think the car slowed down a little bit from that earlier run. I ran in time trial, I ran a 46 with a 5. So I think it's probably slowed up to about a 48. So this will leave me holding about 2 to 2.5. Damn it! Trash! Alright. Just got back from that bonehead ass run. Boy, that was pathetic driving down there. I was so sorry. Give up the stripe by 006. I had him on the tree. I'm 007 on the tree to his 41. He goes a 651 with the 3 on the 650. And I go down there and I'm probably running a mid to low 7, 647. So that was exactly what I thought it should have been, holding 2.5. And I go down there and kill about 6.5 numbers like a moron. I don't know what I was thinking. All right. Here we go. Round 2. First tech card. I'm in the left lane. Dialing a 650. I've been on about a 647.5 to 648, but the sun set, it's getting cooler. And I'm expecting to be all over that 647. So I should be holding 3. But my opponent's pretty quick. He's dialed 60 something. So I need to nail the tree and get rid of my numbers. So I need to just drive more, pay more attention to my finish line driving down there, because I did a bonehead mistake last round. So I'll try to fix all that and get the win here. I think he might have dropped me. So it was a good round. I'm going to stick with the same thing. We're up here for the second tech card right now. I'll be in the left lane. Not quite sure who I'm running yet, but it's round robin, so I'm in a hurry. I can't really know all the details right now, but we'll get it done. Y'all can see me on there, but I got the win. I try to redeem myself on that one. That's the same car I raced last round and give up the stripe to by 6 thou and run 5 over my number. So I threw that out the window and got a chance to redeem myself. I was 18 on the tree and run a 651 with a 9 on the 650, taking 23 thou stripe. So my opponent goes dead on his dial, but he had just a little bit later light than I did. So, good run. Car was running a little quicker. I thought it could be, because it's all, you know, that round particularly, that second tech card, everything's really, really hot. The transmission and the rear end's hot, because that first tech card, we sit for about an hour, then we come back and run right back to back. So, that second hit is always hot. But, good run. I think I was probably on a... I'm probably on a low 7 right there, if not a mid 46. So that left me holding a 3 to 3.5. And got the win. That's all that matters. We're rolling into the third round, double tech. That's what I wanted. Alright. Third round. First tech card. No more buybacks. Gotta win to stay in. I'll be in the left lane again. Sticking with a 650 dial. That should leave me holding about what I think about three numbers. Running a faster car in the right lane. I think he's dialed a 611 or a 617, something like that. But he'll be chasing me, so game plan, same thing it's been all weekend. Nail the shit out of the tree as hard as I can. Hopefully 20 or 25 or better. And gotta get rid of my three. I don't wanna get rid of four, don't wanna get rid of five. I wanna get rid of two, three. So that's probably one good rip as I'm coming up to the mile an hour cone, and then two small rips after the mile an hour cone. And play it by ear. But really shouldn't even be worried about the other car in the other lane. I'm just racing my race. Worried about hitting the tree and getting rid of my numbers. So let's get it done. Back from that round, I lost. I go 002 red. My opponent was 001 and runs a 622 with the two on the 618, but he looked like he got out of it. His mile an hour wasn't really, really high, but I kill it down there and go a 651 with a one on the 650, just practicing my spot. But it actually slowed down a hundredth overall. So If it would have been on what I thought it was, I killed exactly the 300s I needed. But it was on a, probably on a mid eight, maybe a 48 with a zero. But so my opponent's in the right lane, pretty fast car, 566. So I don't really need to pay attention to him. I just need to hit the tree, turn it green, and run down there and kill my two to two and a half numbers. Possibly three if it comes back, if I shallow stage. Let's get it done. Just got back from third round, second tech card, I lost. My opponent's 10 on the tree to my 26. I break out sixth out, he breaks out sixth out. So I don't know how they figured the win. I guess they don't go to the fork number on the time slip. But he got there first by 16th out. Man, I don't know. It shows it only being on a probably a low seven, so I was holding the three, and I only killed two and a half, and I end up killing three and a half miles an hour, and lose a damn tie breakout on a tie down there. So I don't know. Hero to zero, man. I tell you, try it in the shootout race. 25 or better, and it should be on about a 47. So we'll come right back and do the shootout for top. Got back first round, no box shootout. I got the win. I was 37 on the tree to my opponent's 21. He runs a 609 with a 9 on the 05 dial, and I go dead on with the 2, taking 3100 strike. So it was on a good pass. I probably need to dial it down one more. I barely hit dead on. I kind of got lucky, but tough racer I got by right there. So it's probably gonna low 7 or a high 6 that pass. I was in shallow, that's probably why my light wasn't that great, so I could probably get it in real shallow. and make sure to hit it more aggressive and get a little better light next in this top shootout race. All right, here we go. First round of the High Rollers Gamblers Race in Super Pro. Probably running for over 5,000. Probably close to 6 or 7,000 in this race. I'm foot braking it, but my lights have been pretty decent. If I can keep them under 25, I feel like I have a chance. Car's there. I just need to cut the light and be good. I was just 37 on the tree, real shallow, but I'm gonna do the same thing and try to just hit the tree harder, try to be 20 or better. And I'm going with a 648 dial. I dialed it down one. It shows to be on about a 47, low 47 with the shallow stage. So if it can repeat a 47, I'll be holding one whole number, and I just give it a little bit of a rip down there. I got the first round win of the High Rollers race. I was 006 to my opponent's 41, I believe, and I go two over. I was probably going, shows to be going about one under. So right, that was a perfect run where I thought it was gonna be. So it was all good. My opponent ran dead on his dial, and I just had enough on the reaction time to get the win. So going into second round of the No Box Shootout next. All right, here we go. Second round of the No Box High Rollers race. I'm in the right lane. I got thrown in the right lane, so I went up to the 49. I think it's about 1.5 slow in the right lane, but better in reaction time. So I need to make sure to get in shallow. And my opponent's in the left lane, dial 641. All right, here we go. Second round of Super Pro. I'm running a dragster. I think he's probably dialed 470, 480. I'm back in the right lane, so I need to improve on that 35 light. Need to be about 15, and it was running a low 47 or maybe even a 46 that pass, so I'm sticking with the 49 dial. Leaves me holding about 2 to 2.5. I'm having trouble keeping up with the cameras. If I could show y'all how quick pace this is, I don't even have time to do anything. I didn't even have time to get out of my car when I pulled in the staging lanes. When I pulled in the staging lanes, the dragster was already waiting right before the burnout box for me. So as soon as I pulled up there, I didn't have any detail or, you know, time to get his dial or switch the camera to the other side or nothing. So I'm not getting that great of footage, but we're winning. So just trying to do my best. But I was 21 on the tree. He's 15. He goes 96 with an 8 on the 95. And I go 49-0 dead on with the zero, killing 3 miles an hour, 3.5 miles an hour. So, man, that worked. It's fun. So we'll go into third round of both categories, mod first, or no box first. All right, here we go. Third round of the no box shootout. I'm in the right lane again, running pickup truck over there. My friend, my buddy, local guy from Houston. I think he's probably dialed around a 620, somewhere around there. So need to be 20 or better and run the number. Let's get it done. Round of the no box shootout, I got the win. Tough race. I was 0-24, break out by 4 thou, barely won that one. My opponent broke out by 7 thou, so I killed right at 2 mile an hour, but it was close. So rolling into third round of the top shootout, super pro shootout, and then we should be down to 4 in mod, so looking good so far. All right, here we go. I'm back in the left lane. I was gonna try to stick with the right lane since I run it 2 or 3 times in the last few runs, but I got put in the left lane. I'm having to run the by run here in the third round of the High Roller Super Pro race. So I'm sticking with a 649. If I get in shallow, it's probably on a, like I said, nothing's really changed. So it should be on a low 47. I need to get rid of 2, 2.5. I need to be better on the tree. We'll be going down to 5 cars, so I need to nail the tree. Running a fast door car, dial 547. So let's do our job and get it done. Round down to 5 cars in the High Rollers race. My opponent turned it red just barely and runs dead on his dial, man. If he'd have turned it green, it would have been a tough race, because I was on a hell of a run right there. That was the fastest pass in a long time. I went down to 136.9, 60 foot, and down to a 409.9, so that was every bit of a 46 to a high 645. So going into fourth round of no box shootout, down to 4 cars. All right, here we go. Semifinals of the no box shootout. I'm back in the left lane, sticking with a 649 dial. I probably need to kill every bit of three numbers. So my opponent's pretty fast. He's dialed probably in the 590s, I think. So Or I don't know, maybe he's a little bit slower, but either way, I got to be 20 or better and run the number. Let's get it. Going to the finals of the Novak shootout. It wasn't too stellar. I know old Seguin over there, he's a killer racer, man. He's won the Southern Flipbreak Challenge and goes a bunch of rounds everywhere he goes, and we were a little late on that one. I was 40 to his 50. I go dead on with the three, killing 3.5 miles an hour. Car's running faster and faster every pass, but he run two over. And I run dead on with a three, taking 3,700 stripe, but probably took a little too much, but the car keeps picking up, and I was probably holding more than what I thought, the three. I was probably holding close to four, so getting lucky. Next round coming up is down to five cars in the Super Pro Shootout. All right, here we go. Down to five cars, Super Pro, High Rollers. I'm in the left lane, sticking with the 649. I just run it dead on, killing 3.5, almost 4 miles an hour. So I'm running a 460 dragster. So I was 41 on the tree. I need to tighten that up. I need to be 20 or better, and I got to get rid of probably four numbers. So it's going to be tough. I'm not even really going to look at the dragster. I'm just going to try to find a spot and kill what I think is 3.5 to 4 numbers. Let's get it done. Huge round. That was at five cars. We were racing right there for the bottom of the finals. So I got the win. 005 on the tree, dead on with a six on him, killing 4 miles an hour on a 460 dragster. He goes dead on with a two. I barely won that one. Hell of a race. Man, can't believe it. Going to two finals, both high roller gamblers, one for 10. Was supposed to be 10 and one for 5,000, so should be making some pretty good money if I can get these guys to split with me. But man, I can't believe it. Holy cow, we're rolling. Next round will be the finals of the no-box shootout, and then we'll do the semifinals of top, and I'll probably just putt through and go to the finals of both of them, hopefully get a win or two. Man, it's working out. All right, here we go. Final round of the no box shootout. I'll be in the left lane again, sticking with my dial. Same thing, same strategy. Go be 20 or better, and I'm holding probably close to four numbers, if not the full four. So get it in shallow in the beams and try to be aggressive on the tree and knock it out. So. I got a tough competitor in the right lane, Nasty Nick Hastings, footbreaker extraordinaire. He's a bad dude, so he's all the way from Ohio, all the way down here in South Louisiana, 20-hour drive. So he's coming to play. He's been kicking butt. So it's going to be a good final round. Let's breakout. I lost a double breakout. If I could have got lucky and got over my dial, which I wasn't able to kill as much as I wanted evidently, because I only killed about 2 mile an hour. So I needed to kill a little bit more than that. The car actually wasn't even running as fast as it was before, but I got one good rip in early to make sure to kill it, and I just couldn't get rid of it. But I break out, I go a 648 with a 4 on the 649 dial. So I broke out 6 thou, he broke out 1 thou. If I could have just got a few more rips in there and hit him still break out by a thou, I would have run dead on the dial and got the win. But we split the money up really good. And he'll get the big check and champagne bottle. He's been driving his ass off all night. And I think he ended up running up tonight in the main event. So he come all the way from Ohio and been kicking ass, and he deserves it. So it was a good round. We made some money, and I've got the bye to the finals of the Super Pro Shootout, but I'm not gonna have to run it. I'm not even gonna have to make the lap since my car's hot. They told me just go ahead and come back and race the final round. So I'm gonna get my car cooled off and run the final round of the Super Pro Shootout. All right, here we go. Final round of the Super Pro High Rollers race. $10,000 big money check here. Trying to win it. I'll be in the left lane sticking with a 649. My opponent's a dragster, 530 dragster. He's been killing it. So I need to be 20 or better and get rid of the 3 to 4 numbers and hopefully turn the wind light on. So any luck, we'll get it done. Got the win. We got one of them. Foot braked it to the win in the Super Pro High Roller Gambler's Race. Man, I wasn't too stellar on the tree. My guy's 18 to my 44. I killed a lot, man. I killed a ton. I only run 97.9 miles an hour when I should be running at least 103, 103 and a half, almost 104. So I killed probably 6 miles an hour to go 50 with the 3 on the 49. My opponent breaks out by 4 thou. What a damn day, man. What a damn weekend. Started off yesterday, went 13 straight rounds and won the all run race. 9 rounds it took to win it. And I was double teched down to the 6th round and ended up having to race myself. And the way the ladder stacked up, I had to race myself. So that I run myself, and then that went down to 7 cars, so I was able to have a chance at the buy run at 7 and hit 000 when I had to run myself, and that gave me the bye at 7 down to 4, and I ended up winning the next two rounds to win last night. Almost over 200 cars last night, Super Pro and No Box combined. And then today, I had a little rough go at it in the main event, but we come back and made two final rounds in the High Rollers Gamblers races and got one win and lost to Nick. And man, this CUDA is just rolling, man. Oh my God, what a weekend so far. We still got a whole nother day of racing tomorrow. It'll be Sunday, and I hope y'all enjoyed the show. And I don't know if I'll be recording tomorrow. I think we got enough footage for this weekend. And man, thank y'all for watching. And don't forget, we are American Bracket Racers.